Welcome, welcome, welcome. Just taking a little break from the radio show tonight. I'm on till 9 o'clock, but I wanted to get my friend Danielle on the show here from Canadian Humanitarian. There she is. Let me just go and connect with her. Go live with Canadian Humanitarian. Let's do it. Canadian Humanitarian, a great local charity. They've got some big plans for the summer. Hey, there she is. How are you, Danielle? So good to see you.
Yeah, it's so good to see you, too. It's so nice to do a radio interview with a bit more face-to-face interaction.
So yeah, it's so strange. Hey, Mom always said I have a face for radio, so take that, Mom. Yeah. More than that. Danielle, not only is she with Canadian Humanitarian, but she is a certified life coach. Did I get that right?
Yes. Yeah. Actually, I'm a life and leadership coach for women. So I primarily work in nonprofits, and working with Canadian Humanitarian is my primary focus. But I also do life coaching and leadership coaching on the side.
Awesome. Now, I remember it was a while back, a few months ago, I think, you made a post and it really struck me. You said something about celebrating every day. Find a reason to celebrate something every day. And so I'm going to throw that back at you, and I'm going to ask you, what are you celebrating today?
Oh, good question. And I'm so moved that you looked into that. That's great. So I think right now what I'm celebrating is that we're able to kind of slowly in small ways transition back and able to connect with different people in new ways. You know, it's been a really different past couple months. So it's nice to see people still being very safe and you know, practicing social distancing, but seeing, you know, a few more families come together. So that's been really nice. And being able to connect with my family a bit more has been really wonderful.
You know what I'm celebrating today? I went to Costco earlier today. And, you know, sometimes when you get a salad that's like crispy onions on top, right? It's almost like they have a little bit of batter and they're really crispy and they're delicious.
Yes, they are delicious.
I found crispy jalapenos today. I know. And I'm like, I've never even heard of these, but I got to buy a bag. And it's like this huge bag for like $11. And I tried some tonight. I had a little bit of rice and there's some vegetables in it. And then I put these things on top and I'm like, God, that is the most tastiest thing I've ever had.
I need to find these because I love the like fried French onions on salads. So if there's jalapenos out there, then I got to
check them out. That is so good.
Celebrating. Big and small, right?
So, that's right.
Big wins, little wins.
All right. So for those that aren't aware, Canadian Humanitarian, a great local organization, but they're like far reaching, like in an incredible way in Africa and in Central America. A few words, Danielle, on Canadian Humanitarian.
Yeah. So Canadian Humanitarian is a locally founded charity. It's run out of here in Medicine Hat. But like you said, we do have our programs run in Guatemala, Ethiopia, and Malawi. So we're an education and empowerment support program. So we run holistic educational programs throughout those three countries by providing scholarships, by providing healthy meals every day, by providing tutoring, extracurricular activities, and also with a big focus on girl empowerment and gender equality.
Have you had a chance to travel to any of these countries that are benefiting from all this hard work?
I lived in Guatemala for 7 years. So actually when I came on board with Canadian Humanitarian, it was through the organization that I co-founded in Guatemala called Ser Niña through the Real Girl Empowerment Program. So when we formed an alliance with Canadian Humanitarian is when I came on board. So I've spent 7 years in Guatemala, so quite an extensive amount of time. I have not actually been to Ethiopia yet. I just joined the team in January. I was meant to travel in February with them, but due to kind of a personal situation, I delayed my trip by 2 weeks. And if you're planning on traveling at the end of February and you delayed your trip by 2 weeks, you weren't going anywhere. So I have not been to Ethiopia yet, but I am just, you know, chomping at the bit to get over there. I was supposed to go in June, but won't be, of course, either.
What are you hearing from Guatemala or Ethiopia regarding COVID-19? Like, are they being seriously? I'm sure South America is for sure. What's happening? What are you hearing on the ground there?
Yeah, so we're able to talk with our teams over there every single day to really make sure that we have full understanding of the obstacles that they're facing. And the obstacles are a bit, they're similar between all the countries, but they are a bit unique. So in Ethiopia, what we're really dealing with is extreme lack of access to food, The vast majority of our families, over 90%, are informal workers, which means they're fruit vendors, or they work in the markets, or they're farmers. And so when everything shut down, they had no formal income, they weren't receiving a salary, so they have no way of providing food for their families. So the lack of access to food and sanitation products is a really big concern for us in Ethiopia right now, just because there's no income, food shortages are becoming a problem, transportation of food. So that's what we're seeing there. So in Ethiopia, we're extremely focused on making sure that our children have food. We've been able to do multiple food deliveries to all 440 families that we work with. We've been able to supply them with enough food for 2 months. And right now we're just really focusing on being able to continue to do that. It's obviously going to be a long haul in Ethiopia.
Yeah, it's incredible. I mean, you know, here in Southeast Alberta, literally all you have to do is hop in the car, drive out in the country. You see cattle as far as you can see. You can see greenhouses growing all kinds of vegetables. Like, we literally are in the land of plenty right now, right here in Southern Alberta. And so I think it's important for us to A, be thankful, but B, be considerate of those that aren't nearly as fortunate as we are to be in a place like this. And so, Danielle, fundraising is so important. I know, you know, over the past couple of months, it's really thrown a wrench in a lot of the plans, fundraising-wise, for Canadian Humanitarian. But we got some ideas and some good ones, don't we?
Yeah, absolutely. So it's definitely, you know, we have to kind of change the pace with how we're fundraising. Canadian Humanitarian is known for kind of the really wonderful in-person events. We're so blessed to have the support of the Medicine Hat community, you know, for many years through our color runs and our galas, but we can't do any of those right now because of the lockdown. So hopefully later in the fall, we'll be able to do some of those, but we kind of had to change how we're doing it. So we worked together with a group of volunteers and we came up with what we think is a really exciting idea. So it's called the Test of Humanity. And the Test of Humanity, we've run in the past as an in-person bike race, and now we're bringing it all online. And so the cool thing is it can go far beyond just Medicine Hat. So it's an online virtual challenge where people can sign up. They set a movement goal because we really wanted to do something that would be mutually beneficial. Of course, you know, we're happy to be fundraising and have people supporting us in that way, but kind of one thing we're hearing time and again, especially kind of even in my coaching practice, is that people aren't motivated, they're not inspired to be taking care of themselves as much and to be taking care of their bodies. So we wanted to give them that opportunity to set a movement goal, whether it's walking, running, swimming. I guess you can't really swim right now, so that was a bad example, biking, even a push-up challenge. So they set their goal that's really in line with what they want to do. And then they'll reach out to friends and family to ask for their support by pledging or making a donation as they work towards their goal. And then through sharing on social media, they'll let everyone know how they're doing and know that their commitment to themselves and their commitment to their health is also supporting at-risk children in Ethiopia, Guatemala, and Malawi. And so we're just really, really excited about it. We think it's a great way to kind of engage the Medicine Hat community as well. We definitely miss connecting with all of our supporters and all of our followers. So we're hoping that this is a really fun thing for them to do as well.
And so is that over the course of the summer, or is it like just in July, or what are you guys thinking for a time frame there?
So we are launching it right away. So people can already sign up. It's the testofhumanity.com. And it's actually throughout the month of June. We've never done it before, so we wanted to keep it really manageable, set people up for success. I think a multi-month goal for me would not even be that great right now. So we want to do it throughout the month of June. People can sign up, you know, after it kicks off. If they sign up June 5th, no problem. But it's throughout the month of June. And our kind of symbolic goal is to walk around the world. We're saying, you know, our programs span all across the world. So we're trying to raise $40,000 to represent the 40,000 kilometers to walk around the world. So you can see right now there's a map showing kind of how much of the world we've walked around. And it's itty bitty right now, but we're hoping that'll change soon.
All right, Danielle, I'm challenging you to run or jog 40 kilometers in the month of June. It's not that much, right? It's only a little more than like a kilometer a day.
Yeah.
Can you do that?
I'm actually aiming for 75, so I can definitely meet your 40.
Did I say 40? I meant 80.
Oh, cool. Okay. Well, that's a little bit of a push for my 75, no. but I should be able to do it. But it's great. Now I have you holding me accountable. So there's one more reason to be committed to it.
All right. Learn more. Is it on the website, CanadianHumanitarian.ca?
Yes, .com, actually.
.com.
The easiest way to get directly to the Test of Humanity is testofhumanity.com.
Okay. testofhumanity.com. I am going to put it in the description below here and learn more about it right there. If you don't know a whole lot about Canadian Humanitarian, find out all the information right there. I'm a believer in all that they do. I think it's important work that needs to continue, but it needs funding, right? So we can all get involved in that and make a big difference. All right. There you go, Danielle. Thank you so much for joining us here tonight.
Thank you. I really appreciate the opportunity. And it was nice to connect. And it's so great that we can do it on radio, but also face to face.
There you go. It's perfect. All right. I got to get back to work here. The radio show's on right now. So I got to get back in the garage where we're doing the show right now. But you have a great night, you and all your family. And we will talk to you very, very soon. Okay.
Great. Thanks so much. Have a good night.
All right. Bye-bye. Take care. All right. There she goes. That is Danielle. And she is with Canadian Humanitarian. Great local organization. I'm a firm believer. And let's help them out. All right, I got to go, guys. Have a great night. Stay safe. All the best. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. That doesn't narrow it down at all now, does it? See you later. All right.